Hey everybody, it's Warren. I'm back with another tutorial. I got a new hairstyle, I got a new guitar. I don't know what's going on. It's like crazy up in here. The universe is upside down. But hey, I'm glad to be showing you guys Knives Out tutorial today, okay? The Knives Out tutorial. This is long awaited by some. But before I get started, I just want to shout out to Nathan Thomas Jung, Susan DiNicolo, Panza Hout. You guys totally earned this shout out. And everybody, backers, I'm loving this guitar. Loving it. Okay. So let's jump right in. This song has a lot of parallels, kind of similarities to Paranoid Android. So the first chord of Paranoid Android, very similar to this voicing of C minor that Tom uses. However, there's one difference, okay? And you're gonna add that ring finger right there. So in order to be able to play that, I got an email. In order to be able to play that, you gotta wrap your thumb around, okay? So midget hands, you're probably just gonna have to do a barred C minor, which is 8, 10, 10, 8, 8, 8. Probably won't sound as cool, but you know, hey, stretch your thumb out. My left thumb's actually a little bit longer than my right. I don't know if you can tell. It's because of guitar. I'd like forced it. It's kind of sick and gross when you think about it. But 8 10 x 8 8 x. That's your C minor. Okay, so you're gonna do this strum here. It's gonna go 1 2 3 and 2 3 and 1 2 3 and 2 3 and. Okay, so what did I do? I just went from C minor to a B flat major, okay? So that's 6, 8, X, 7, 6, X, okay? Now I'm using my thumb, ring, middle, and index, okay? Now again, you can do this barred if you're having trouble with the thumb. That's just gonna be 6, 8, 8, 7, 6, 6, standard B flat bar chord, okay? So no, don't worry about it, everybody there with midget hands, don't worry, you just keep at it, okay? So C minor, I don't know if you noticed, I was doing a little bit of melodic movement, okay? So it's like bum 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 on the B flat, okay? So what I did was I used my middle finger to add the ninth fret. Dun 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 dun, you'll hear it. 1 2 3 and, okay? Then I went with my pinky, which is on the 8th fret there. So 1, 2, 3, and 2, 3, and. All on the 2nd string right there. All the melodic movement happens on that string there. And the next chord is A flat, okay? So A flat, major 9, no 3rd. A flat, major 9, no 3rd goes X, X, 6, 8, 8, 6. Okay, and you gotta kind of bar these four strings with the index finger. That's the easiest way to play it. And then you go to 6 7 8 6. Okay, so you change that chord a little bit. You add a little bit of a sharp four in there, kind of funky. So let's time all of this. Okay, so 1 2 3 and switch and 2 3 and you gotta switch on the and 1 2. So it kind of comes in, that weird 6 7 8 6 chord, it comes in on the and of one there. So I'm going 1 2 3 and 2 3 and 2 3 and 4. Okay? And that's going to bring us to our next chord, G minor. Now this is the parallel to Paranoid Android again. Same two chords, it's just 3x0 3 3 0. Kind of a funky note, but Tom leaves it open. Okay, and that takes us to E minor 6, but 3x0 3 3 0 to 1 3x 2 3 0 to E minor 6. Okay, now this is the chord that kind of makes the song, I really think. This is like the essential chord. And you got 0-2-2-0-2-0, okay? And this is just a really cool chord. I like it. So you might be asking, how do you come up with all these kind of notes for a fill there? Well, that happens to be the chord that Tom and Johnny both like to kind of fill on, especially in this acoustic version. And really, it's a different fill every time. And if you want to be accurate about it, you would kind of basically have to go to the source of like what's their insight into that chord that allows them to kind of improvise there. Well, it's called the E Lydian scale. What the heck is, actually, sorry, not Lydian. It's E Dorian. It's an E Dorian scale. And you guys are like, what the heck is an E Dorian scale? Well, it basically means 1, 2, flat 3, 4, 5, 6, flat 7, 8. Whatever, you know, just as long as it's from Lydian and it's kind of in rhythm, and when you play it confidently, you know, it's just, it sounds like you totally know what you're doing. That's the trick, is even if you make a mistake, just do it confidently. So that brings us to the next section, which is the chorus. Okay, so knives out. It's just your standard A minor X02210. Your A major over G, or an A7 in third inversion, whatever you prefer. 3x222x. Okay, so if you notice, to do this, I'm doing kind of a half bar with my index finger, the same way you would play video games, you know, like you kind of mash down your index finger. You see that mashes down? Well, it mashes down perfectly on three strings for most people's hands. Okay, and then you just add your middle finger there. Okay, so now this is also a very Faust arpy kind of chord. If you go check that tutorial out again. So catch the mouth, which is the next part of the chord. You got D minor, standard D minor bar chord, X5-7-7-6-5, and then D7 over C. So it's a D major over C. It's a D7 in third inversion, I should say. 8x777. You got the same thing again, where you're barring three strings and then playing one note on the sixth string like that. And then, okay, here, kind of weird, okay? So now you just put three, your index, your pinky and your ring finger on the first and second string. Kind of similar to a G chord, okay? But you're not playing a G, because your index finger is going to be free, kind of moving about, doing this kind of melodic thing. So practice that, where you go first fret, fifth string, third, okay, third fret, fifth string, then first fret again, open fifth string, third fret, sixth string, okay? So what am I talking about? It goes like this. So again, that's just first fret, fifth string, third fret, first fret, open, third fret, sixth string, open, fifth string, third fret, sixth string again, and then first fret real quick to E minor add six. So there you go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. I'm just counting along. Sorry. I'm just counting along to that melodic movement there. And that's pretty much the whole song. It's not easy to sing and play at the same time. I was actually struggling quite a bit with that. But keep working at it. It's a really fun one. And thank you so much, guys, for sticking with me, for believing in me, for supporting me. Yeah. I hope to make many, many, many more videos. So take care. All right. Peace.